This is a best of the best of this material from the four audiobooks that are in itself a best of thousands of pages spoken by a channeled personality that has no material form and calls itself this. Most of the material was mainly channeled in the 70s by Jane Roberts, yet it's more current than anything else and will always be the most current. It has to be installed again and again in order to realize and imprint the power of yourself within. The basic statements that turn all we know is that we create all reality, the context in which our body takes place, and all physical world. That there is no outside, that we dwell in God, and we are the masters that can change through conscious intention and intensity, not only the future, but the past. It's a completely different concept of time. All things ever happen simultaneously, at once, and our point of power is in the present. I regard this material as the most important ever, because it matches with what can be experienced in shamanic realms of ayahuasca or DMT, what is a body-owned neurotransmitter, and salvia divinorum. Here I refer to Lucid Dream, the book, part 2 and 3, for more information about these. It's building up on the knowledge that comes from the deepest portions within. It also matches with what we can grasp when we dismiss our outer senses and focus on the inner realms. These statements are such a great support that they are already manifested in form of books, because the same statements just told out of DMT hyperspace journeys would not be taken so serious. So here follows a best of the best of Seth's quotes, mixed with live stream comments that happened with me during recording. During the records, I am connected through ayahuasca to all higher dimensional selves, so that my kind of speaking is also a kind of channeled information. And on later recordings, I will retranslate the German Talkings with Thess book in English, and it will be filled with many examples and experiences where you can indeed apply all these godly skills. And this is how we change everything, how we reprogram reality when we go conscious, when we realize that we are the manifestors of our world.
The nature of personal reality. You can change the picture of your life at any time, if you only realize that it is simply the one portrait of yourself that you have created from an unlimited amount of probable ones. Whenever you are trying to rid yourself of a dilemma, make sure that you do not concentrate your attention upon it instead. This acts to cut out other data and to further intensify your focus upon your difficulty. When you break that focus, the problem is solved. A sudden conversion may completely rid an individual of physical symptoms. Any kind of conversion. Under that general term, I include a strong emotional arousal and fresh emotional involvement, affiliation, or a sense of belonging. This may involve religion, politics, art, or simply falling in love. How everything you experience is a theater, where you are the actor and the director, at the same time. You just forgot that you also wrote the act that you are now playing with your life. Many ways that it will happen, because it already happens now, your fulfillment to this higher dimensional entity, which is a tree that has many souls and many selves. And your present reality is just one, how is it called? You know, when a tree, before it gets fruits, there is this little dot where everything is inside, and this is what your life is for this tree of life of many, many souls and personalities that you have. What Thess tells and realize, Thess is not an external character that has a strange name and you don't know what you can relate with it. It is a character that you formed, that you manifested him, and the book that you read or this audio that you hear, because this information somehow has to reach humanity. We will feel it like it was now, and it is happening now. It is just, we have to really drop off our linear experience of time. It is, there is no sooner and no later, it is all now, and you overlay all probabilities and parallel realities. Also of all your lives, how your incarnations went, it is not one defined line. Remember, these mental associations are living things. They are formations of energy assembled into invisible structures. So what thoughts create is not material form, but it absolutely, it creates your structure, your world lines. Your world line is connected in a higher term of when you derivated and derivated, that means what is the change of the change? The change of the change of your structure, the structure behind the structure. So what do you paint in your life as your world line? Where you are at which time, and what do you create? What effect do you create that has an effect to later and former, and like spreading seeds and flowering them? Ayahuasca is so helpful to see your life and what you do and the meaning behind as a sparkling artwork. Universe is inside of you. Thoughts thrive on association. So realize that your thoughts have an imprint of self-protection. You have to take a higher seat in the cinema of your life and to see that your thoughts are the ones that created also the proofs for your thoughts, that you are caused to think they are true and real. But it was only the thought that projected itself. And when you change the belief system behind, then you find the proofs for your new reality. Just have to look behind the structure, and then you see that you created this system with all its politics and consumption of 11 planets and whatever, in order to dense up and speed up the process of evolution, to bring you this printed media as a maximum dense. I also couldn't do it without our beloved capitalism and the system that is, this is, it is just a story. There is no, it was just until you realized why it was there. Yeah, it was very important to be balanced in your energy, and when you are, and when there are things that annoy you, that shape states where you don't want to live in, then don't deny it and don't get along with it. But change your life. This is not something, because this would make you sick if you are in a frequency field of things that do not fit to how you want to be. And for many people, this means that they should first go out of a relationship and find the highest joy in being alone and self-love and the inner world. And when you're strong and a flowering wonderful being that is just perfectly not addicted to any other people and reactions and whatever patterns, then the ones that fit to you in symbiosis will settle and dwell around you. And the best thing to do so is start and go on a rainbow gathering and watch Lucid Dream audiobook 4 about rainbow gatherings. This is not optional. This is really one of the basic things to learn how humans will live on and already live for centuries on this planet in balance, in harmony, in peace, and what highly developed swarm and community being and living means. About the reincarnation. On the one hand, it is highly distorted. On the other hand, it is a creative interpretation, as the conscious mind plays with reality as it understands here. But in the terms here, there is no karma to be paid off as punishment, unless you believe there are crimes for which you must pay. In a simultaneous time, punishment makes no sense. The punishment as an event, and the event for which you were being punished, exist at once. And since there is no past, present, and future, you could just as well say that the punishment came first. In larger terms, there is no cause and effect either. So these are root assumptions in your reality. We return once more to this moment of reflection, for it is here that both causes and effects first appear. Animals, each in its own degree, far less than yours, show that reflection. In sum, for all intents and purposes, it does not exist at all. Yet it is there, latent. So there is no cause and effect, because time is not linear, but every events happen at once, simultaneously. This changes all. These multiple existences are simultaneous and open-ended. In your terms, the conscious mind is growing toward a realization of the part it has to play in such multidimensional reality. It is enough that you understand your part in this existence. When you fully comprehend that you form what you think of as your current reality, all else will fall into place. You just have to realize this, that there is no reality, it is all illusion created out of yourself. Your beliefs, thoughts, and feelings are instantly materialized physically. Their earthly reality occurs simultaneously within their inception. But in the world of time, lapses between appear to occur. So I say one causes the other, and I use those terms to help you to understand. But all are at once. So are your multiple lives, occurring at the immediate realization of your being, in the natural extension of its many faceted abilities. At once does not imply a finished state of perfection, nor a cosmic situation in which all things have been done, for all things are still happening. You are still happening, but both present and future selves, and your past self is still undergoing what you think is done. It is so interesting to get this new look upon everything, every event that happens when you switch to multidimensional, simultaneous time. Think of your thoughts as living electromagnetic cells, differing from the physical cells in your body only in the nature of their materialization. Your thoughts direct the overall functioning of your body's cells, even though you do not consciously know how the cell operates. If all of your beliefs, not just your fortunate ones, were not materialized, you would never truly understand on a physical level that your ideas create reality. If only positive beliefs were materialized, then you would never clearly comprehend the power of your thought, for you would not completely experience its physical results. This is what he says. We have to take responsibility for our thoughts. Like breath, just so your lives go in and out of you. You and yet not you. And a portion of you, by letting them all go, remembers them and knows their journey. So the lives you have lived are not you, while they are of you. Close your eyes. Think of your breaths as lives, and you the entity through which they have passed and are passing. Then you will feel your state of grace, and all artificial guilts will be meaningless. Think of the greater you, call it the entity if you want to, as forming a psychic structure quite as real as your physical one, but composed of many selves. As each cell of your body has its position within your corporeal space and boundaries, so each self within the entity is aware of its own time and dimension of activity. So the entity or greater psychic structure of which you are part is aware of a much larger dimension of activity than you are. In this regard now, and for the sake of our analogy, think of the life of the self as one message leaping across the nerve cells of a multidimensional structure. Again, as real as your body. And consider it also a greater moment of reflection on the part of such a many-sided personality. Yeah, really take your time to let this sink. Your own present identity contains the knowledge and memory of all those simultaneous existences. For example, I am dead for other eyes who carry me as a memory. Consciously, because of your time concepts, you will interpret those simultaneous lives in reincarnational terms, one seemingly before the other. Yet they are all happening simultaneously. You, however, have free will, as opposed to the cells. For while the entity's psychic structure can be compared to the body, it is a part of and inhabits far greater dimensions. All of this may seem to have little to do with your personal reality, yet your daily experience is as connected with your self or entity as it is with the cells of your physical form. You are a part of your soul. The entity or greater self is composed of souls. The entity has its existence in multitudinous dimensions. Its souls, free to travel within boundaries that would seem infinite to you. Souls make up the life of the entity in those terms. Yet, the entity is more than the soulless. When you are aware of the existence of the entity and of the soul, You can consciously draw upon their greater energy, understanding and strength. The results will be felt down to the smallest cells within your body and will affect even the most seemingly mundane events of your daily life. Your understanding and desire are so important. The processes initiated are beyond your normal awareness. They occur automatically with your intent, if you do not block them through fear, doubt, or opposing beliefs. Imagine yourself, here's an exercise. Imagine yourself as a portion of an invisible universe, but one in which all the stars and planets are conscious and full of indescribable energy. You are aware of this. Think of the universe as having the form of a body. If you want to, visualize its outline brilliant against the sky. The suns and planets are your cells, each filled with energy and power, but awaiting your direction. This is so great, as you could hear again and again. The whole universe is your body. Then see this image exploding into your own consciousness, which is unbelievably bright. Realize that it is a portion of a far greater multidimensional structure, spread out in an even richer dimension. Feel the entity sending your energy as you send energy to yourselves. Let it fill your being and then direct it physically any place within your body that you choose. This is what you can experience so one-to-one in ayahuasca, where this is no theory, but this is what you experience deeply. Any event of your life is written in the memory of the universe, as you think of it. Basically, senseless statement, since any idea is physically materialized at its inception, at the moment of its inception injection, even if not experienced later. Every idea materializes physically. Know that later you will still operate through another form, but that the body and the material world are your present modes of expression. This material world is a paintbrush of your expression. What you think of as the self dies and is reborn constantly, as the cells of your body do. What you call the ego is a portion of the inner identity that rises to face the world of physical existence. It's the surface of your identity that faces the physical existence. The greatest idea of all, and the greatest step to any illumination, is the realization that your exterior life springs from the invisible world of your reality through your conscious thoughts and beliefs. For then you realize the power of your individuality and identity. You are immediately presented with choices. You can no longer see yourself as a victim of circumstances. You create not only the body, but its entire experience, the context in which it takes place. This is powerful. You create not only the body, but its entire experience, the context in which it takes place. So you create any physical world and material, and all events and everything just springs out of you. There is nothing external that you were just born into. You, your higher self, gives birth to all this all time, all events, all matter, all trees, all animals, all people as well. They are cells inside of you. It's all one collective dream. The natural healing of sound can happen also when you do such a simple thing as listen to the rain. You don't need drugs, hypnotism or even meditation. You only need to allow and direct the freedom of your conscious mind. Left alone, it will flow through thoughts and images that provide their own therapy. And therefore I recorded how it sounds in a trailer when it's raining. You really miss this part when you live in a flat. And I recorded it, for, I guess, for half an hour or something. This will be an extra music sound that I release on SoundCloud or YouTube. It's then called Raining in a Trailer. Yeah, and here we hear a little bit of it. What do you think of yourself, your daily life, your body, your relationship with others? Ask yourself these questions. Write down the answers or speak them into a recorder. But in one way or another, objectify them. That's really an important step, yeah? Take time to do this. Otherwise you will not realize, and once you started to realize your patterns of beliefs, then you can more and more get aware of much more fine structured beliefs that there are set on different levels in your daily life. Even the intent to know yourself, to face the reality of your experience, can be of great benefit, generating emotions that will provide you an energy, an impetus to begin, your inner sense of balance. It is not a matter of rising above your nature, but evolving from the full understanding of it. There's a difference. Get a full understanding of your nature, and from this point on, you evolve. You can learn more from watching the animals than you can from a guru or from reading my book. Oh yes, this is so true. Just draw back into nature and watch and be silent. Natural aggression is the creative, loving thrust forward, the way in which love is activated. The fuel through whose agency love propels itself. Belief systems are as necessary and natural as physical organs are. In fact, their purpose is to help you direct the functioning of your biological being. Saturn represents the part of all that is, or God, who stepped out of himself, so to speak, and became earthbound with his creatures, offering them the free will and choice that previously had not been available. Is also part of us. This is part of the free will. The birth of imagination initiated the largest possibilities, and at the same time put great strain upon the biological creature, whose entire corporal structure would now react not only to present objective situations, but imaginative ones. This is why self-healing works so well via just going into meditation and illusioning yourself that you are healed yourself cannot make the difference between something that happens real and is just imagination. Because you have free will, you have the responsibility and the gift, the joy and the necessity of working with your beliefs and of choosing your personal reality as you desire. Yeah, when you have almost every night lucid dreams where you control every single thing and you have not one night but you have two sleeping periods, as he suggests, then you are much more used to controlling all reality and controlling all reality in both states. This is why this can really be beneficial, but to live this you have to get far away of any patterns and not work and not have any date and schedule and you have to live in then this works when you get one in nature, then you can make a siesta and use this for a second dream period. And when you get a light human, in German it's Lichtmensch, so I always say light human, it is breatharian, it is the ones that live just without needing food, intelligent, then you need much less sleep, you need so less sleep, but you meditate and rest, but you don't need only 3 or 4 hours, but you can use it much more consciously, and you have almost every night then lucid dreams automatically because your digestive system is not distracting you. You can eat what you want, but it is many things are distracting you from what is real of importance, and so therefore really the living and raw food movement has a big living energy behind it. The body itself can be physically refreshed and rested in much less than 8 hours. And after 5 hours, the muscles themselves yearn for activity. This need is also a signal to awaken, so that unconscious material and dream information can be consciously assimilated. One of the biggest quotes. We are in God. We were never externalized. Everything we imagine and know is inside. There is no outside. Because of your psychological and psychic structure, there is within the rich makeup of your being endless variety of what you may call probable selves. In one reality or another, these will all be experienced. In your present existence, however, you will utilize only those psychological characteristics that you believe you possess. The overall private experience that you perceive forms your world, period. But which world do you inhabit? For if you alter your beliefs and therefore your private sensations of reality, then that world, seemingly only one, would also change. You go through transformations of belief all the time, and your perception of the world is different. So you seem to be no longer the person that you were. You're quite correct. You're not the person that you were. And your world has changed. And not just symbolically. This is how we change everything. We go conscious. We realize that we are the manifestors of our world. And we manifest it firstly in our mind and in our emotions. And secondly, and much, much later in what we do in 3D and what we do with material and with our hands and whatever. So first go into your mind and clean everything up that you have to. If you alter your beliefs,
your world will change.
Cannot repeat this often enough. You seem to be at the center of your world. Because for you, your world begins with that point of intersection where soul and physical consciousness meet. In surface terms, the sense of I that you possess is the result of constantly emerging probable identities, giving continuity in time through the physical apparatus of the body with its built intervals of nerve reaction. The nerve pattern's activity therefore causes the illusion of a present, in which your consciousness appears focused and alert. Impulses possess a far different reality than physicists or biologists suppose. As you think now, past is still occurring. Past events continue. Consciously, you only experience portions of events with your corporeal structure, yet the structure itself records them. Yeah, you get into these states via dream, via meditation, via DMT, via psilocybin that is similar to DMT, that is acting DMT-like. But the most direct way is ayahuasca. The past does have its own past, present and future, therefore. This is really multi-freaky. It remembers me so much what happens when you open up and go into Salvia Divinorum. You see all this parallel past and futures, and in one moment you are all of these events at the same time. And really, in a conscious Salvia experience lies the experience of ego death. All surface that you thought that is you, it is just melting down, and you see everything, and you are everything. Past, future, present, and items, and everything, and it loops and loops, and you get a much better feeling for this, what also Thess tells, and it was 40 years ago that it was recorded, and is more current than anything, and it will always be the most current topic of all. Even in the next and next and next reality, this is the really why this should be in stone, and it is, yeah, and why I can, why I feel I have, this is one of my last tasks to make here this best of as a version that everyone can understand, therefore in two languages, and I hope many will feel inspired to share it more and more. Because it's easy language and easy to understand for everyone, and this is the biggest awakening that you don't have to wait for any other things that it will get someone somehow better. You really have to change all everything inside of you. So here he talks about that the past does have its own past, present and future. From a given past event, you will only materialize a particular future, but the event itself continues and possesses a dimensionality of its own. Or rather, a multidimensionality that you also possess. You can dip into cellular memory, for example. Using memory, you follow but one recognized sequence of remembered events backward. There are elements in your past that are as unpredictable, however, as the elements in your future now appear to be. There is creativity in your past waiting for you, even as there is in your future. But to utilize such experiences, you must learn to alter your beliefs, and to some degree escape from the particular kind of limited conscious focus that you habitually use. Sense data can be organized in different fashions. mechanisms, physical ones, and pathways exist, making it quite possible for you to see sound or hear color, although that is not your primary habit at this time. It's funny, you have these senses, your senses can be organized that you see sound or hear color. This is also what you can experience in deep ayahuasca. Alright. A new belief in the present can cause changes in the past on a neuronal level. You must understand that basically time is simultaneous. Present beliefs can indeed alter the past. Present beliefs can indeed alter the past. For example, in the spontaneous disappearance of disease, certain alterations are made that affect cellular memory, genetic codes, or neuronal patterns in the past. A sudden or intense belief in health can indeed reverse a disease. But in a very practical way, it is a reversal in terms of time. New memories are inserted in place of the old ones, as far as cells are concerned under such conditions. You have to consciously insert, let this happen. So get rid of your memories about any sickness or any disease. This kind of therapy happens quite frequently on a spontaneous basis, when people rid themselves of diseases they do not even know they possess. Learning is also passed on through the body's present corporeal reality, sometimes entirely changing the messages to past cells that in your terms no longer exist. A strong belief in a particular ability generated in the present will reach into the past and effect whatever changes would have to occur there in order to now make the ability apparent. So just by conscious mind you can, from one day to another, have a new talent. Try it. Accelerated learning takes place when under hypnosis or otherwise a present individual is convinced that he or she is, for example, a painter or a linguist. The present belief activates latent abilities within each person. Latent means latent, already there. The biological structure as it existed in the past is therefore affected. Experience is built into the organism that it did not have before, in your terms. As far as you are concerned, the present is your point of action, focus and power, and from that point you form both your future and your past. Realizing this, you will understand that you are not at the mercy of a past over which you have no control. You may say, I was born in a house on a certain street in a certain town, and no present belief to the contrary will change that fact. If in the present, one past event can be altered within your neuronal structure, however, then basically no event is safe from such change. Someone supposes that you could even change where you have been born, because there already were multiple realities where your mother could have given birth. This was just not up to now into our focus, but it becomes more and more where this life is the transformative one. You really have to YouTube, Google Mandela Effect and watch some videos. It is arbitrary. They're all telling the same and they're using lots of proofs that are in the end irrelevant. But you have to spend this time to realize
that we are already living in a world where all history is not one line, but there are many, many proofs for different lines how history went that can be found. Because it's up to the observer. We are the observer that is defining what he wants to measure, like in quantum physics.
Cellular memory can be changed at a point. Present beliefs can insert into the past new memory, both psychologically and physically. In daily practical experience, concentrate for a while upon seemingly subordinate abilities. Once you think of as latent, of existing but not yet activated. If you do so consistently, using your imagination and will, then those abilities will become prominent in your present. The current beliefs will reprogram and alter past experience. It is not simply that past, forgotten, unconsciously perceived events will be put together in a new way and organized under a new heading, but that in the past, not now perceivable, the entire bodily response to seemingly past events will change. Definite reorganizations in the past will occur in your present, allowing you to behave in entirely new fashions. During certain stages and sleep states, you short-circuit the neurological structures and perceive experiences of a multidimensional nature that you then attempt to translate, as best as you can, into stimuli that can be physically assimilated. Hence, you often convert these into symbolic images that can be understood and to some extent reacted to by your bodily structure. Such constructions often bear a similarity to the inner architecture of the cells and to planets. Your dream images are biologically structured then. The experiences behind them bring you in contact with the deepest portions of your non-physical reality. The unconscious translates these for you into recognizable images and forms. In the same way, your unconscious also transforms for you from an otherwise undifferentiated maze of reality, fields of activation into recognizable objects and events in your daily life. The same way as dreams translate your higher self, this is how your life translates your higher self. Your higher entity. Your higher entity, where you can really, this is so helpful to see you functioning like a cell, like an organ in your body that does not know about the reality you perceive. It would say, wow, really cross, if it knew. And this is what you say when you know about the what it means to be the being of. You can switch into this. It is like the cell would be able to switch into your experience for a while, so you can see your life as a cellular structure, and it has so many cells and organs clustering together and to one big artwork of expression and creativity and love and intensity and joy and all this. So the entity in its own way possesses what you can think of as future neuronal structures. You form your corner of the universe, which is itself a part of another one. Within this, the actions and beliefs of one affect all. Each part is vital. There is an instant communication between the smallest and the largest, and each spins its own web of probabilities from which other universes continually spring. I say she. and here he unites the sides. Wisdom and foolishness would be seen as aspects, one of the other. Wisdom is an aspect of foolishness. I haven't seen this ever like this. You can draw into your present life some knowledge and intimate connections with your own probable realities. If you think in terms of a multidimensional self, then you will realize that you have many more avenues open to expression and fulfillment than you have been using. Your imagination can be of great value, allowing you to open yourself to such courses you can then use to help you to bring these into being. And my imagination goes into metamorphosis, literally cellular, biological, metamorphosis, multidimensional, where every cell grasps its multidimensional memory, past, future, and projects how the transformation to this multidimensional always aware, where you are just flowing in DMT hyperspace all the time, and you jump into physical realities, and then you jump into non-physical realities, all conscious. And you're not anymore a slave of any habit, anything that you offer in your thoughts, any words, and any food, any outer relations, or any material or parents. You're just, yeah, this is what I will map it, I will fulfill it, yes, absolutely. That's why I draw back sooner or later into a cave. And then that's it. In your mind, see those probable abilities or events taking place. As you do, the intensity of your desire brings them into your experience. There are no boundaries set about the self. So there is nothing that is not possible. Imagine that you can run out and say, yoo-hoo! That is the best thing about life. Just did not yet realize, but once you did, really this is the stuff that is sacred. The only reaction you can bring is to cry deeply touched. Yeah. There are no boundaries set about the self. There are literally many other probable use. You can draw upon their abilities, as in their own way they call upon your own, for you are all intimately connected. You must realize that you indeed are a probable you. Your experience is the result of beliefs. Your neuronal structure necessitates a certain focus so that other experiences, counter to your conscious assumptions, remain probable or latent, not yet experienced in your with your senses. Alter the beliefs, and any probable self can, within certain limitations, be actualized. What you must understand is this. Each of the events in your lives was once probable. From a given field of action, then, you choose those happenings that will be physically materialized. Each belief can be seen as a powerful station, pulling to it from fields of probabilities only those signals to which it is attuned, and blocking out all others. You can change the picture of your life at any time, if you only realize that it is simply the one portrait of yourself that you have created from an unlimited amount of probable ones. The abilities, strengths, and variants that you may want to actualize are already there, in your terms, and at your disposal. Your present convictions will act like a magnet, activating all such past issues, happier said. Your present is at the point where flesh and matter meet with the spirit. Therefore, the present is your point of power in your current lifetime, as you think of it. Sit with your eyes wide open, looking about you, and realize that this moment represents the point of your power, through which you can affect both past and future events. If you learn to get hold of this feeling of power now, you can use it most effectively to alter your life situation in whatever you choose. Exterior conditions can always be changed. As your knowledge grows, so your experience becomes more fulfilling. Your point of reality and power is in your current experience. You don't have to wait for a later life or for dying. A realization of this would allow you at any age to draw upon qualities and knowledge that existed in your past or will exist in your future. Your ages are probable. This is very dense. Your ages are probable. That is one of the artist paints we play with. Time does not basically exist as you know it. You are neurologically forced to perceive your life as a series of passing moments. Animals do not deteriorate in the same way. Action is thought in physical motion, outwardly perceived. Again. Action is thought in physical motion, outwardly perceived. Here comes a point of power exercise. A correctly utilized 5-minute period of time can be of great benefit. In this period, concentrate upon the fact that the point of power is now. Feel and dwell upon the certainty that your emotional, spiritual, and psychic abilities are focused through the flesh. And for 5 minutes, only direct all your attention toward what you want. Use visualization or verbal thought, whatever comes most naturally to you. But for that period, do not concentrate upon any lacks, just upon your desire. This is a quite mighty workshop that you can install regularly. Manifesting your godly, multidimensional reality. Use all of your energy and attention. Then forget about it. Do not check to see how well it is working. Simply make sure that in that period your intentions are clear. Then, in one way or another, according to your individual situation, make one physical gesture or act that is aligned with your belief or desire. Behave physically then at least once a day in a way that shows you have faith in what you're doing, and act as if you were in complete abundance. The belief in the present, reinforced for 5 minutes, plus such a physical action, will sometimes bring literally awesome results.